episode of BB Mini Cooking Show. I'm BB.
And I'm Mimi. Welcome to my kitchen in Perth.
Ooh. What are we doing today?
Okay, so our friends are moving house today, so we thought that we were going to cook some food for them today.
You'll be making this?
Yes, I'll be making a marron roll, which is a West Australian version of the Boston lobster roll. And after that, I'll be making a creme de cassis sorbet.
Okay, I'll be making some peanut butter brownies then. And then we'll be taking to the house to visit them
yes.
in the afternoon.
Yes.
And we'll be making some drinks too, do you think?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so first let's boil the marrons. The best way to boil the marron is put them in the freezer first for about half an hour, and then they'll fall asleep. It's easier to boil them then.
But they don't look like they're falling asleep, so we might have to put them back to the freezer a bit more?
Yes.
Okay.
Once the marrons are cooked, it should take about 5 or 6 minutes. Take them out and put them into an ice bath to stop the cooking. And leave them in there until they are fully cooked. Fully cooled.
Oh, so cute. So it's my turn now to make peanut butter brownies. So I have all my ingredients lined up here. 160 grams of sugar, caster sugar, 105 grams of butter melted with a pinch of salt.
105?
Yes.
It's very precise.
I have tested it. That's the right amount. And 2 lightly beaten eggs, room temperature, and 2.5 tablespoons of peanut butter. I sort of melt it a little, just heat it up a bit to make it more liquid so it's easier to spread in a bit. And here I have a mixture of 15 grams of cocoa powder and 50 grams of plant flour, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and my secret ingredient, 20 grams of chocolate powder.
I have a question.
What's
the difference between chocolate powder and cocoa powder?
Oh, okay. Because I have tried making just with cocoa powder. It seemed to be a bit more hard, the texture for the...
Like dry?
Yeah, drier and harder texture for the brownies. But if I added some parts of chocolate powder in there, it would make the brownie texture a bit more chewy. So I think I like that.
Okay.
I hope you like that too, you can try later.
Okay.
So this amount of ingredient will make normally about 11 to 12 of these little muffin tin size pan, but if you don't like to spread them out in that, you could actually use a normal 8-inch cake tin.
Like this, you mean?
Yes, correct. Very good. So we'll start by stirring in the sugar into the flour mixture. And once this is almost equally stirred, we add some butter, but alternate them, don't pour it all in at once.
So half?
So maybe half of that.
Okay.
And then once that is somewhat combined, we can alternate that with egg mixture.
Half?
Yes, half as well. So at the end of the stirring, you should get some consistent, shiny, dark chocolate colored mixture that looks like you're ready to go. So I'm just going to scoop this into my little paper case.
Would you recommend using an Asian soup spoon?
Oh, that's just, it will be faster than a normal little spoon, I find. So, and then you will scoop some bit of peanut butter and put it in there however much you like. Actually, if you like it more peanut buttery, you should just melt more peanut butter earlier and just add them in. And then if you like, you can cover that a bit more with the chocolate mixture, so then they look like they're having some marbling
effect.
Yes, like this. Okay, so I have all this batter poured in evenly, I hope, into the tin. So we're just going to put it into the oven, 140 fan force, for about 10-15 minutes, but we'll check it again with the skewer in a bit.
Okay, I think it's time to check on the marron. So the marron is fully cooled. And now it's time to deshell it. First, you remove its head, it comes off quite easily, as you can see.
Wow.
And don't neglect the claws, because they have a lot of very delicious meat in there. We'll get them out later.
Quite hard to get them out?
Not really. Show you in a bit.
Okay.
Sorry about that. So, we are going to try and place it as flat as possible, at the tail as flat as possible, then cut through the middle, like this.
Wow.
And there, you have two halves of the tail. And then you can take them out of the shell. And dice it. One way to get the flesh out of the claw is to use the back of the knife.
Whoa.
And knock onto the shell. As you can see, it's starting to crack. And from there, you can take the flesh out.
Wow.
Yeah?
Very good skill you have there, Mimi.
Thank you. So now we make the mixture for the marin roll. So we have the marin all chopped up, and then we add mayonnaise.
So, what sort of mayonnaise is that?
Full egg mayonnaise, but I prefer to use Japanese mayonnaise because that's my favorite condiment.
Mine as well.
So enough mayonnaise just to coat all of the marin. And then I've also diced some celery. So just one stick of celery should be enough for this amount. And also I'm gonna chop some chives.
Do we need any other seasoning?
And salt and pepper. Okay, so we have some brioche buns, and what I'm gonna do is to just slice the outside. This is what they do for Boston lobster rolls.
Wow.
Okay. And then we will spread some butter on the outside. On both sides. And then at the same time, we have a pan being heated, and then we can toast both sides of the bun. So when both sides are nice and brown, we take them off, and we can start filling it with the marin.
Wow.
And now we have our West Australian marin roll.
So my brownies are cooked, so I'm just gonna leave it out and they have to cool in the pan.
Okay, so now we'll cook the crème de cassis. So on a hot summer's day like today, I think a sorbet will be ideal. So first, we'll combine equal parts of sugar and water. In this case, I've used half a cup of each. And then you bring it to a boil and until all the sugar is dissolved. Okay, when the sugar syrup starts to boil, take it off the heat and pour it over some frozen berries. So here I have about 700 grams of frozen berries, mostly blackberries, raspberries, blueberries, and cranberries. Okay, so you stir it through until the sugar syrup is no longer hot.
Oh.
Yes.
So you have to sort of melt this frozen fruits with this.
It's more that you don't want the sugar syrup to be hot because you're adding the crème de cassis in.
Okay.
Yes.
They look pretty, they look like Christmas already.
Yes. So now the final step of the mixture is to add in some crème de cassis. You can add in however much you want. Obviously, the more you put in, the nicer it will taste.
So we can put in like as much as we want, really?
Yes.
Okay. Would it work with some other flavor of liqueur?
It should, yes, it will. But, you know, only because it is so delicious. One of my favorite liquors. Okay, so once it's done, we can put this through a food mill, or you can use a blender, but I think it's very rustic to use a mouli.
And you can burn some extra calories while doing this?
Exactly. Work out my arms. Okay, so when the solvent mixture is processed, we can add it into an ice cream machine.
Wow. So how long would this take?
It might take about 45 minutes to fully chill.
So that's it?
Yes. And start. That's it.
We're on our way to deliver food.
Can't wait to see our friend's new house. Hello!
Hi!
We are here to deliver food.
Wow!
Cheers, Mimi.
Cheers, Mimi.
Thank you very much for watching Bibi and Mimi Cooking Show Episode 2.
See you in Episode 3.
Bye. Always remember to put your marin to sleep in the freezer first.
Otherwise, you end up like this.